some more parts for the wagon motor. This cap, it's a new old stock, standard products. It's pretty good quality cap. It's got the copper or brass terminals that have the backing behind them, instead of like some of the cheap ones you get nowadays. It's a really thick cap, pretty good quality. I bought a whole box of stuff and there were some of these in it. The box was falling apart, I've done threw it away. But yeah, these distributors, I gave $10 for the pair. I bought them at a Bronco show with a swap meet. It was in Townsend, Tennessee. I'm gonna clean them up here, inspect them, see which one's in the best shape. That'll be the one I use.
Started
putting some more of it together.
Set a distributor in there. We're gonna run. Kind of made up the plug wires. There's a Petronics flamethrower. 8mm wires for the old style cap. Yeah, I also picked those up at the swap meet. Kind of wire brushed and painted the pulleys and brackets. Got those on. Bolted the headers to it just to see about, you know. One thing I do on these Ford thermostats housings is go ahead and put the thermostat in. Take some 3M weather strip adhesive and go ahead and glue the gasket on and let it dry. That holds the thermostat in without falling out. Because a lot of people, I've seen a lot of them, that where the thermostat slips down when they put it on, and actually they tighten it up and crack the housing, because sometimes it's difficult to hold them to get it down in here because the timing cover interferes. Just a little quick tip. And the thermostat's one of those Robert Shaw 180 old stock high flow style that I picked up at the flea market a while back. Getting a little closer to putting in. I could have already had it setting in, but I'm wanting to actually build me a engine run stand. So I think I'm gonna try this week to get the engine run stand put together and break this engine in on the run stand. Well, I've got a new old stock Robert Shaw PCV valve out of a bunch of stuff I'd purchased. I really like the new old stock stuff when you can get it. This carburetor, just a 600 I'm gonna run. I ain't a real big fan of them, but they're cheap and I have several I've accumulated. So like I said, this is strictly just gonna be a driver. It's a electric choke. So got a fitting here that I'm going to put in it. I'm going to run some push lock hose from the fuel pump to the carburetor. Just seems like anymore these days you just can't get any good fuel hose.
I've been using this push lock stuff. My local hose supply place where I get my fittings and things, they sell the push lock hose for it was $2 a foot, but now some new owners have taken over, so I don't know what it's going to be. But basically any of your sizes, the -4, -6, -8,
that's basically the only sizes I've been buying. But any of those were $2 a foot no matter which one.
And that stuff is compatible with alcohol, gasoline, diesel, transmission fluid.
Put that fitting on there that I had, that Barry Grant fitting. Put it on here, and here's some of that push lock hose. It's something that I've had.
So I was test fitting the hose, and with the way it comes out at that angle, it was going to run it right over here by the
oil field, the breather.
I was going through my fittings. I had this fitting here, so that kind of reroutes it.
I like it a little better. Got a fitting ordered that goes from the inverted flare to the AN. And then this fitting here will screw onto it, and I'll put the push lock on it to it. So fittings are supposed to be here tomorrow. So, but I think that'll be okay. Kind of looks kind of crappy.
Different fittings, but most of that's under the hair cleaner you won't even see. So